We're going to see if Team Secret are going to be able to bring it on back in this one. I'm Lyrical Dota, joined today by Danny Lee Cass, as well as Corrupt Drop on the stats. And you know what? It all comes down to this. This is it. If Secret end up winning this one, I think they still have the chance. It goes to ultimate tiebreaker mode. I think that it's going to be something along the lines of like a four-way tie, depending upon how the other matches break. And otherwise, they're probably out.
I'm wondering how they're going to do the tiebreak, because if it does end up being four-way, I guess they'll play all four games simultaneously. It shouldn't be any different.
Two
games simultaneously, sorry.
It's coming down to almost unprecedented territories. I'm not sure if there has actually been a four-way tie in the group stages like this before. I'm sure it's happened, but not in recent memory, at least. And you know, it's something that you don't necessarily want to have to deal with, but I'm thinking if you're Team Secret right now, you definitely won't have to deal with, because that's your only way to go through at this stage. But we're going to go right on into the game here, because this is really something interesting to me. We haven't seen a whole heck of a lot of change. The only big difference is that now Team Secret are going to be the ones that end up going for the Earth Spirit Complexity. Again, we're able to take the second pick, but instead we're able to, and also on the Dire side. But the big thing that's different this time around is that there isn't going to be an Invoker, and instead we're just going to be taking the Earth Spirit for Secret Self.
Yeah, but we have to remember, last game, Z-Freak handled the Earth Spirit, and every time he was on point with his spells, he always caught Envy, always caught Heroes, the Silence, the Sables. Like, he played a really great Earth Spirit. We didn't really say much during the game, but he really did some great stuff in the background. And so it's just Team Secret saying, we don't want to deal with an Earth Spirit, we don't want to ban it, let's pick it up ourselves, let's make the most of it. So they've got this Earth Spirit, let's see what they're going to be able to do with this. Whereas for Complexity, going to pick up the Darkseer this time. So nothing from last game, very solid offlaner though.
I think that this makes sense. This is a hero that we've seen Swindles play time and again. He's very comfortable on it, much like his Slardar. I think that this speaks a little bit more towards Complexity wanting to... I think that they were happy with how that last game went, but given that they don't have the Earth Spirit, I think that he was very central to that strategy and making sure that they had the follow-up stuns that they needed to be able to deal with an Ember Spirit. And I think that given the record, they'd actually be pretty happy to be able to have Team Secret pick an Ember Spirit again, as long as they're able to find the problems. And I think that if you are going to go for the Darkseer first, you need to be able to take that Oracle in the later stages. And the thing that I'd be curious about is if Secret are able to pull something out like a Disruptor a little bit later to make this one of the other counters to Darkseer in lane.
Yeah, they absolutely could pick up a Disruptor. We didn't see it normally anymore, as a lot of other support sort of outshine Disruptor, and Disruptor's not really great when it comes to progressing with the objective. So if you really want to, they can, but instead they're going to pick up the Lone Druid first. So they picked two Complexity's heroes from the previous game. They are very strong, I will say that, but for Team Secret, their draft is looking very open right now. They can honestly do a lot with this, whereas for Complexity, they can't gauge too much over this, except for the fact that there is going to be already a lot of pushing potential with just the Lone Druid on his own. I would expect Complexity to at least put a little bit of emphasis onto controlling the Lone Druid during the laning phase and not letting him get free farm like Chessie did last game.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's really interesting that they didn't opt to go back for that themselves. I guess that, you know, knowing that the Team Secret were going to probably end up picking it up, to me at least, this tells that there's something in this Darkseer that they really want to get out of it. And I'm not sure what that is. I think one thing that you could look for now for Secret to do is try and grab another support player who can roam on over to that hard camp or the side camp for the off lane and try and block that off, because that to me feels like another really hotly contested point. And if you're able to keep Darkseer from being able to farm that, then he has to be forced to rotate all the way over to his own jungle, which is, you know, it's a relatively long walk. You lose out on probably maybe one or two waves of experience, maybe even three with the walk there and then the walk back. So those are, you know, really relevant in the early stages of the game. It might even be something where we end up seeing him pick up an Iron Talon and do it so many other jungler or so many other offlaners have done and just start in the jungle for a little while. I don't know. I don't know if you necessarily have to, because you're normally going to be able to get at least a little bit of experience out, but depending upon how Team Secret draft, that is an option.
It is, although I wouldn't expect a Darkseer to pick up an Iron Talon, like Iron Shell. It's like so good farming.
That's a good point.
So why invest the gold. We'll have to see. The best coming out from both sides, Witch Doctor and Sven. So, interestingly enough, Witch Doctor receiving a little bit of hate. I haven't seen much Witch Doctor this tournament.
I think that EG were running it at Star Ladder, and I'm not sure if they've been running it still. He's still a pretty popular pick, I think, mainly to deal with Chen. He's one of the heroes that can effectively deal with creeps really well. But he also is just a really strong lane support. I mean, he's got the sustainability, a pretty great ultimate in terms of the damage it's able to deal. Oftentimes it feels ineffectual once it goes to around, like, you know, the late stages of the game in which Doctor's stuck at level 9, because that just seems to be the level that everybody gets stuck at. But I think that it would be pretty good here. Just those sort of instant disables are something that are really difficult to deal with. And Lina also going to get taken out. The Sven makes sense also. If you're wanting to run sort of one of these pushy types of strategies, you want to take away as much armor as possible. So that's something else to keep your eye on. And Team Secret, still their most played hero is still the Dazzle. So if they wanted to go for that as a fourth or third pick, it wouldn't be the worst one in the world.
It would give them a lot of extra sustain, but the problem is that it doesn't give them much room when it comes to trying to aggressively. Because Dazzles can't kill you. You can poison touch him, just surges away. Like, what's the point?
Yeah.
So I would like them to see. I would like to see something from Team Secret to give them a little bit more respite. Like, Earth Spirit's fine and hell, but you want that extra support to make it a little bit easier. Especially chasing down the Dazzle. Bounty Hunter ban complexity, so it seems that they're a little bit worried about a early roaming bounty potentially shutting down their mid or poking at the mid. Does this mean they're picking one of the more fragile in this game? Because normally that's one of the reasons why you don't get rid of a bounty. You don't want to have a weak ladder shut down more by a bounty.
It certainly could be. We're going to see the Spirit Breaker taken, and that would kind of support that idea, because they'd want somebody who can be that sort of up front and center person in your face. I was wondering if maybe Complexity were going to run an offensive jungle. I've seen that happen with Enchantress every now and then as part of a dual lane, but with the Darkseer Spirit Breaker now, to me at least, like, you've got this very tried and true aggressive dual offlane that can get run. Oracle is going to be the sole support because of that, and to me this makes sense that if you wanted, if we did see Team Secret run a Bounty Hunter, they could just throw the Lone Druid in the safe lane and be perfectly content with that, with Earth Spirit and Bounty Hunter roaming around the lanes and making kills happen. So I think that's the main reason for it, is that they wanted to run this dual aggressive offlane and keep Oracle as a solo support. And they knew that if they did do that, then Earth Spirit and Bounty Hunter would be able to probably run on up there and just go wild on their safe lane.
Curious to know if Plexity made it for a 3-4 aggressive dual lane with Oxy Spirit Breaker. Because if it's the Lone Druid safe lane, you can potentially kill the Lone Druid. Until Bear gets entangled in claws, he is vulnerable to getting picked off because they're naturally fishy.
Definitely. I think that's, I would imagine that's what they're going to try and do. The Rubick is a nice answer also. A very strong laning. Well, he's weird. His spells are great in lane, but him as a hero isn't the best. He's very much about that positioning, and he does have a long-ranged attack, but particularly against a Darkseer Spiritbreaker, you can close down that distance. The main thing that you're going to be looking for here is that telekinesis, being able to keep them off of the lane, and I think also a sort of not often talked about part of his kit is that null field, which is super relevant. I mean, you take a look at it, it ends up being 20% magic resistance at the maxed out level, and even if you end up taking like one level in that before you max out your telekinesis, it's a super value spell, that's, you know, to even creeps now as well. And considering that you've already got a decent chunk of magic damage that's coming out from the Darkseer, the Oracle, even the bashes from the Spiritbreaker, all of that's pretty relevant.
So, seeing how the Rubick plays out, this also gives Team Secret another potentially good support, as Rubick is set up for not just Druids, but what admit they're picking up for we. Actually, going through quite a bit of reserve time this fourth pickup. They need two more cores, they need a safe lane as well as a mid. Is there anything that sticks out even for Complexity?
I think Invoker's already taken. Other ones, Quap would be okay. It's something that, like, I think. Oh, OD. Huh.
Is this mid or safe lane OD though. I've seen a lot of safe lane ODs yesterday.
I would actually like safe lane more. The combination of him with Oracle and that Essence Aura is so good. I mean, being able to, the fact of the matter is that Essence Aura works really well in conjunction with people who can spam out spells consistently, and that is just all Oracle's game. Spectre taken now also. I mean, this is currently, I believe that they are 3-0 on Spectres when they have it. It's like one of the, I mean, obviously one of their highest win rates, but one of their best heroes, and I think it's just because he gets to this sort of nigh unkillable point. And this makes a lot more sense to me also. The fact that they've ended up picking up the Rubik Earth Spirit, I'd just be a little bit worried about the early aggression that could come out with the Spirit Breaker Darkseer lane. That to me feels very, very scary with this Spectre.
So we're running into a similar situation last game where Complexity is looking to exert early game pressure, Team Secret Hope to fall back to a later portion of the game to sort of bring them back in.
Yeah.
They're running Shield and Vector, and both of these heroes need a lot of farm. Obviously, Vector needing more farm alone can still do a little bit more than Spectre without a farm.
Mm-hmm.
But they're going to have to heavily distribute farm on these two heroes. They're going to need mid that's going to be able to be a tempo controller, but also not require as much gold to sort of do what they're supposed to do. What mids are available that can do that? Okay, there's the pushing potential for Complexity. Oh.
Okay, so it's going to be an OD in the mid lane. That also limits your options pretty heavily. You can't really run DP here, I don't think. Jeez, I don't even know. They need it to do so much. Like you said, honestly, Invoker is the best answer. But they needed to take that out of the pool because they wanted to run the Earth Spirit themselves. I mean, I almost feel like they need somebody who's got the control of a Magnus, but I think the main reason that you end up picking something like a Mag is for that Empower, and while it's okay for Spectre, it's not the best.
Yeah, it's not ideal.
No.
We'll see what they want to pick up. We've got 22 seconds left on the clock, but overall with the two drafts... Oh, Disruptor. So... It's going to be a core Earth Spirit.
Yeah, that's something that we did see happen in a previous match. I don't think that it was Secret that ran it. It could be, but very, very interesting. That I mixed feelings about. You are pretty good because you can. It's still a super versatile hero, and he can do a lot of the things that you need him to do. But damage-wise, he can be a little bit lacking. The plus side is that I don't think that there's, like, a natural defusal carrier. Oh, you know what? I think Oracle can purge his ulti, too.
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, jeez.
Oh.
Well, I think that it'll be okay.
It's not completely terrible for Secret, though. You have to... They've got a lot of options. They've got Disruptor, which is one of the best chasing heroes in the game, just as a glimpse. Silence is great versus what? The entire draft of Complexity. The only hero that any heroes that probably wouldn't have would be maybe the Darkseer, because he can survive a little bit of it. Like, can just shift. He's worried. Like, shapeshift, he's fine. Obviously, OD is going to be very vulnerable. It gets caught in the static storm from the Disruptor, so he's going to be very careful with his position on this OD. But a Secret don't have the best damage, and if you look at Galaxy's heroes as well, they're mostly naturally tanky heroes too. Mm-hmm. So this might come to bite them in the later on, but if Secret play maybe a 5-man progression with the Envy going for aggressive haunts, then I think they could pull it off.
Yeah, it's going to require really good coordination. It's going to require, you know, min-maxing those abilities whenever possible. And it's just going to be a very hard game, I think. But if there's anybody to do it again, it's going to be them. This is their style of play. This is what they like to do, getting Envy as fat as possible and then just throwing them on in there at them. And we'll see if they're going to make it happen. But for the side of Team Secret, we got Misery is going to be playing on the Lone Druid in the off lane. Also, Pileidai on the Rubik. Wii is going to be playing the Earth Spirit. We do have Puppy on the Disruptor. And last but not least, Eternal Envy is going to be playing that Spectre.
toward the top lane. We've got Chessie handling the Lycan. We have Limp on the OD. Hanscan gonna be handling our Oracle. Z3 comes break, and we have level 1 engagement yet again. 4 versus 4. They're gonna try and jump onto Limp, but he's not taking that much damage. The level 1 AP, the secret's not gonna be working out so well. They do get the disruptor. Limp will be following shortly. There comes Burst of Complexity to come for some revenge. Who do they want to jump onto? They can't get Wii. Try and chase Twilight Die, but it seems that's pretty much be the end of it. They get killed on the disruptor, but they lose the OD.
Yeah, and he also didn't end up getting the rune. That was the Rubick that ended up getting the rune. So really well played there. Secret starting off right. That's what needs to happen for them. And the downside again is that you're a melee hero coming in as an Earth Spirit against an OD. This could be a bit of an issue. He's going to be losing all of that intelligence. The plus side for Complexity is that this is going to be a really nice lane for Swindles in the off lane here. Eternal Envy does have the 8 tangos, which he's definitely going to need that damage over time. It's so frustrating. But it's going to be a hard one. I don't know. I'm wondering if eventually they're even going to need to bring over the Rubick once the Spirit Breaker starts charging on into the middle of everybody.
They might have to, because Disruptor and Spectre in itself is a very thick dual lane. Like, these two have little kill potential. Spectre can throw staff daggers. Disruptor doesn't have the best damage out of the supports out there. So killing a Darkseer or Spiritbreaker is almost out of the question up until they either get level 4 each, or they have to bring in the Rubick, then they try and go for a kill, but even then, it's not guaranteed.
No, definitely. And I think that probably the biggest thing that you're going to need to keep an eye out for is TP rotations. They're going to keep on throwing out those daggers to, you know, try and get some more last hits and apply a little bit of harassment. Just look at this. Z3 can run right up into their face, and it's so hard to deal with. Top lane, they're able to get a decent chunk of harassment off. We did manage to see the druid apply a little bit of spank into the wolf there, which is nice. Had to pop his first salve, so Chessie taking some. He's not going to be having a ton of regen off the back of this, but even still, it's not as good of a matchup down here. The sort of head and true aggressive dual offlane. And other than Spirit can run around whenever he wants, they do end up throwing down Iron Shell as the charge is on the internal Envy. Disruption is working. He's going to try hits a couple more time, only gets one of the bashes, and is going to have to back on out.
At least he has that extra regen with. So even if he's receiving a lot of this pressure, I presume he's going to have to buy extra regen outside of these tangos to just stay in this lane. I wouldn't be surprised. If he does, then he will be forced back down to completely reach HP. That's not a situation that you want to be as a Spectre. You want to stay in lane.
No.
The bottom lane can be a bit of a disaster. Outside of the bottom lane, if we take a look mid, Wii is on par with Limp on this OD. He is playing phenomenally on this. That's very yes.
Yeah, definitely. Ooh, a little bit of like spike there, but no big deal. Yeah, it's really impressive. He's been able to make it work for him. It's not something that I would have completely and totally expected, but you see the issue right there is that he's still taking a ton of harassment, and he does have his bottle now with the regen rune in it. So these things are starting to work out, but still, it's a bit tough. He is going to pop that now as he heads on back forward to get a couple more last hits. The thing to keep in mind also is that you look at Limp right now, who's got, you know, his null tally up, his fairy fire. He's ready to keep on trading hit. He can play much more aggressively as we do have the Rubick rotate towards the bottom lane here.
Well, if they can grab a kill on these heroes, is Eclipse available on Puppy yet? No. Only put 2 points into Thunderstrike. He's holding onto another point. So he's thinking about keeping that as soon as they want to switch up and go either Glitch or Kinetic Field.
Yeah. Well, we do have the Spectre out of regen now, so he's going to need to keep an eye on this, because as soon as the Spirit Breaker starts to come in, this is where things get really difficult. He's going to do the pull off to the side to stack off the camp, which is really helpful for Swindles, but Swindles now is going to start to stalk over into the lane, and we do have Pylai Dai with the Arcane Rune coming in. He's going to try and see if he can make something happen. The charge goes towards mid, though, this time around, as realizing what's going to happen, we do see Wii run away. The charge is going to keep on going through. Gets canceled at the last second.
Yeah. So now jump onto Wii in the meantime, down towards bottom, getting a kill onto the Iron Druid. So all cut off the back completely, trying to control him up here. Here comes Wii and Pylai Dai. They're trying to jump on Chessie, it seems, but it doesn't seem to be working. They will get a bit of a stun off, but it's like Chessie and Hanskin are going to overpower Wii and Pylai Dai. It looks like gonna get out of murder. There's no real counterplay coming out from Secret. They will try and jump on ahead instead of the weaker target. gonna try and shoot that in the tree line. Doesn't quite, it gets knocked out by me, but it comes with charge. Is going to connect? No. Jobs freak. And that's too, it's too dangerous.
That still is a kill on the lone druid, though. Like, being able to trade that for the oracle is so good. And I think that this is sort of just another instance where the lanes are slightly weak for Secret. You have the Spectre, who needs a ton of sort of ability to be kept alive here, and that means that you have to bring the Rubick down to the bottom lane, and then your space creating hero, or one of your space creating hero rather, is forced out of there. And look at Spectre, 79 HP right now, and honestly, it's just going to be forced back. He has four tangos that just got brought out to him, but it's such a hard game for him right now.
Yeah, it's very difficult, but it's a what can you really do? If you can't kill him, you're going to have to take the full brunt of the damage. So it's not like he's died. So he's still not getting SDS. It's not a situation that you want to be in if you're a Spectre, especially with the kind of drop that is running.
Oh, he's going to pile up.
Three weed as well. Can the kill? Our hands get incredibly low, but let's go to Asriel. He wants to pop the hands. He's just out there free as the sea coming in the back out. A little too scared of my support kill.
Well played there. You try and rotate on over and be able to get down a ward or something like that. It doesn't quite work out. Also worth noting, you do end up dropping an observer right in view. Are they going to be able to find it?
Oh, back with the glimpse.
Yeah, this is the scary part right now, is that you've got the constant worry that you're just going to have a Spirit Breaker charging on into your face, and unfortunately, there's not a whole heck of a lot that they can do about it. I mean, you've got Glimpse to send them back, but you see now that Disruptor's forced out of lane. Like, if they want to, they can potentially dive this. They need to be ready with TPs almost immediately from the rest of the side of Secret to be able to defend against this. They throw the Ion Shell in on top of Z-Freak. They're ready to go. Nobody is here.
I just put a ward down, and he's moving back in the lane. He has a TP scroll, but honestly, if Puffy's not to be there with Envy 100% of the time.
Yeah.
Good thing he didn't get dunked on there, so that's good news, Secret.
I think that they're still a little bit scared of maybe diving a bit too deep. Handskin is up in the high lane. They didn't. She get down this ward, so they're going to have complete and total information. And they're actually looking for him. Oh, God, they spotted him, didn't they?
Oh, they do. They should have seen him. Ground vision. Bet.
Okay. Apparently he blends in. It's all good. Mr. Oracle hiding.
couple of shades too blue. Then Pi's gonna come in. Oh, did they see him? It's by him.
That doesn't look like it. They should have
seen him. Oh, that's the central. Sorry. But an observer just now.
How did weird is that? Him? No.
I don't need hand skin.
Huh.
I guess he was out of range of the spirit vision high ground.
Yeah.
Maybe they
it
do know.
Nighttime.
Don't care. Who knows?
that's definitely it.
Just give him a bit of a wave from behind. Hey, man. Hey, how you doing?
Well, we're going to continue on here. Taking a look at net worth. Currently, OD has been able to zoom ahead towards the top. Oh, maybe are going to be able to run on in here. Wee is going to get jumped. He kicks away Chesty. They are going to be able to run away from this one, but I think he's still going to end up going down. Astral gets dropped. What the heck just happened? Oh, my goodness. That hero is ridiculous. That's so weird because it looked like the Astral had gone through, but apparently it was just dropping his ultimate. So they rotate three heroes, pop the Lycan ulti, as well as the Outworld Devourer ulti, and don't manage to get the kill there.
That's cool. On the Sandy's clip, so not getting a kill sort of hurts him.
That literally blows my mind. I cannot believe, I totally thought that he was dead and just like, it's like, is Chen in the game? Did he get sent back? What the heck just happened?
It's just like the Storm Spirit Zippy Fee.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go for a jump onto E that Lee Freak does have the Iron Shell and run back and he can get after this. He has no ultimate knee. Thinking that Jesus think the surge from Swindle is gonna keep the team alive a little bit longer. Because E is low now, if he's too kind of pain, leaving Swindle's here for a little bit, but the supporting crew, Pi as well as Puppy, coming from the north. Swindle, well, he might be in trouble. He has surge available, but them should be right from Puppy. Even if Swindle's left, I just would have been sent back. And so we go, kill Secret. And completely getting a little bit too overconfident on killing E there.
This is a really good play here. I mean, Envy, it looks like he's also going to be going for the urn build. So he's going to be playing that more aggressive style that you were mentioning. And maxing out Spectral Dagger means that it's doing a significant amount of damage. He's also got that 1 point in Desolate and the one in Dispersion, which allows him to hit that a little bit harder. Across the board, I think this is played out just about as well as you could. They've got the control that's going to be coming in from the Earth Spirit, and then you've also got the follow-up Magnetize, because right now it is going to be able to be purged by an Oracle, but you're still going to be able to do a decent chunk of damage. And it looks like they're going to jump right in on Testies. They throw in at the Thunderstrike. A couple more hits. They are going to throw the Magnetize, but it ends up getting taken off. There is a Fate Edict to be able to dispel any magical damage that's coming in, and it looks like Chessie's just going to be able to run out of there. I think that he does still fall to this, though, as they're getting taken on down, and yeah, Earth Spirit is going to get that kill. We do have Haunt available if they want to use it. Puppy getting jumped on, and they are going to be able to get that kill. They think about it. They go for the Haunt. That's a kill onto the Oracle. Now turning onto Limp, he does get the Astral Imprisonment, and he's going to be able to TP out.
Yes, a great kill is coming out from the Secret. That opportunity to go in there, and to just spoon a kill to Envy like that, it definitely helps him set up farm for the raids. And that was what I was expecting from Secret, to even bring in Eternal Envy to get those kills. They can't afford to have a AFK farm for the entire duration of the game. And this is probably going to be a story of Secret this game. Just bring a team, trying to go for those kills, doesn't know what you're running, just try and go as possible. He's trying to get a Glimp off, but Glimp is trying to juke through the line, and he won't him.
Sorry about the lag, everybody, trying to sort it all out for you guys, as we do end up seeing Z-Freak cancel the charge. They jump in on him, get the silence off. He's going to TP immediately. They do not have... Oh, they do pop the glimpse for it. They're going to continue the chase. Bear's going as well, but I don't think that they find this kill. Might be able to kill off the bear if they're not careful, and I'm just going to leave it alone for the moment. But the tier 1 tower has fallen in the bottom lane, and looks like Swindles is going to be in a little bit of trouble here as he's going to TP out. Do they actually glimpse? They do. No, okay, not going to be able to make it happen. The Pylai die charge, wanting to rub Rubik's head into his face.
up though. Looks like Chessie managed to take a tower down, but Wii's here with Magnetize, and so our bear is here. The stun is like, well, they can end the bear. It doesn't really matter. It looks like Chessie's in off. So rest in peace, he took an hour, but here comes reinforcements. Limpers coming through Astral straight on the Wii. They want to try and get the Earth Spirit at least. Hands seems like they're gonna come in. Is the Fortune's End gonna be enough? He's gonna be able to run out of charge. Coming through from Z-Freak, he kicked onto Wii. Here we go. Does have the ult? No, no. He's only level 5, but they do have off Earth Spirit in the end. He's not over the tree line, which is high. He just TP'd straight out of that back to the T2. He will be coming back out with Misery on there. And yeah, they're all going to move towards the mid lane now. And we could Puppy in a lot of trouble.
I still think, though, that... Yeah, all right, here's the reinitiation of the charge, and Puppy's going to end up going down. They're getting enough right now for Spectre that I think they're going to be in an okay spot. Like, once you're able to pick up that Radiance, if this is neat is what he's going to want to go for, he could be going for the sort of more diffusal stats build, and you know, you get on up the Mantis style pretty quickly and do all the damage with the Desolate procs coming in, considering he is maxing out Desolate after the fact. This to me feels pretty strong, and I think he's going to be able to fight more quickly than Ember Spirit is, and he's also going to be able to fight in a different way. I think they have a good chance to keep going here and not really get brought off guard. But again, you've also got the Darkseer now picking up the mechanism and also has his cloak up. They're going to go in and take Roche, and this is going to be a highly contested point in this game.
There is only three heroes to complete here. Secret just waiting in the wing. They're all smoked up. They can put Envy in. They're waiting for the opportunity. In the meantime, there's going to be a charge onto the EE. One that can't now, it doesn't matter. OD has already taken the Aegis. Now we've got everyone on Secret trying to go for a trip. Here we go. We have a beautiful ult coming from Limp. It doesn't quite take anyone down. So yet they do shut up the Elise, but they're still on the retreat. Swindle's going to try and come in. They will try and finish up playing at least. And he's being chased by the big bad wolf chase. He does get some grits in. Not too lucky with those, but he does have the Iron Shield charges. Really pulling it into Envy. It doesn't look like they will finish him off those. Spectral Dagger's a higher grade. Too late, but ages and two kills for completely losing.
Yeah, they did have to buy back on the Spirit Breaker, but it's not the worst in the world. I think that they're still in a pretty strong position. It's going to come down to how quickly they're going to be able to take these towers. Like, they don't have the same amount of push power that they did before with the bear, and that's really, I think, what ended up winning them the game. The solo rounded draft, you've still got the wolf who's going to be able to push pretty hard, but it's not nearly as much. And I'm wondering even if we're going to start to see some necro books coming out from these other heroes across the map. Like, you don't normally expect to see one coming out from the Darkseer or from, you know, the OD, but those are items that do gain a ton of value from just having the Lycan in the game. This puppy is just going to get chewed on a little bit by these wolves here. Oh, got another charge.
Oh, game's frozen. And I had a bit of a lag.
Turtle NP bottom lane getting charged up is going to get hit there. The wolf is coming in from behind. They don't have enough damage to bring him down, though. He is deceptively tanky with this drum and as well as the urn. Like, 1200 HP and also having dispersion off the back of it. It's really hard for them to actually find a kill.
Yeah. But it forced three heroes to rotate in the bottom lane just in case complexity was to kill. So, just using up a little bit of time here. You're really pushing that much, but they are trying to aim the bear as well as the spec. Now I'm curious. You have a lone druid as a spectre. In this situation, like going double rating to use the Valorous after having the first one, do they change it up? Say, like, a lone druid picks up the radiance and then the spectre picks up the deep you're talking about? Or are they
definitely. No, I think you definitely go for the stats build here on spec. You want to be able to pick on up that Manta style, get the bone, like, because the haunt still, one of the best ways that you think about haunt is either A, being able to be that big team fight ulti where you deal a ton of damage with radiance and cancel TP or cancel blink daggers, all that stuff, or alternatively, the ability to find pickoffs on the map. And still, if you haunt in and then reality in and then Manta style immediately onto a lone target, that's going to be dealing at max level, what is it, 65 pure damage times 3. It's so significant, and they're going to be able to charge it here over onto Wii. He needs to get the heck out of dodge. Does still have rolling boulder. It's only level 1 though. Oh, he ends up canceling. It does get astral though, and I think that this might just be about it for him. If he had another roller, it might have been able to be enough, but they do take the turn around silence onto a couple. They are going to reality here to another hero. They get the spectral dagger already out. Hanskin's going to fall pretty quickly. Meanwhile, Swindle is trying to run down Puppy. They are going to get the secondary charge through as the false promise has already been popped. Z-Freak still stays alive. Vacuum wall onto two. Darkseer is already taken down. The Disruptor. Pylite Dagger going to fall as well. Eternal Envy trying to get out of there as we're going to keep on getting chased down. Veil a second time through as it looks like he's going to get bashed. A second jump in from Jesse and we is going to fall. Too much damage too quickly. Does buy off the chainmail, but oh my goodness gracious. They are not at all afraid. Complexity look to be able to do it. I mean, Earth Spirit does finally take down Limp at the end with the bonus damage over time, but oh my goodness.
Straff, it look, it's paying off. In theory, if they can drag the game long enough for Lone Druid and Spectre to get those items, they're in a really good spot, but it doesn't seem like they're going to be able to build it that long. I crumble when, unfortunately, I think it's just too much emphasis or too much pressure on Wii's shoulder to perform for the team. And it looks like Envy just jumped on Z-Freak a little bit. They have support coming through and he just goes for the TP bash. 17%? Nope. No 17%.
Yeah, that is lucky that didn't happen. That would have probably been close to GG. Well, time will tell. It does look like we, oh god, are they going to realize that this is going on? They definitely spotted him there with the Observer Ward, and the Invis up Limp is coming after him. Astral Imprisonment is ready. He has another Force Staff in 9 seconds. Wanting to cut him off at the pass, not going to be able to happen, and they're going to have to stop the chase and back on out of there. Oh wait, no, he's rotating over. Oh god, no. It's not going to go well.
Trying to get Hanskin into position. Okay, there's the Astral. Andrew kills the Darks. We did get to that, but we might see the death on people we need. He's deceptively tanky, and looks like he's homey.
Oh, it's really well played. So they do get that kill, a 1200 gold swing off the back of it, and that going into Lone Druid's pocket is huge. He does have his relic already, and the Radiant's pretty soon. There's the Haunt back in. Is going to be able to get out of there. It looks like Sackstorm onto a couple. They are maybe going to be able to get this kill, as he's already Astral'd himself, so he's going to be able to get out of there. Chessie taking a lot of damage. Lycan needs to get out of there as quickly as possible. Two-man stun, as well as the Magnetize coming in. Chessie's going to end up pulsating. He's Eclipse following it up. Eternal Envy is dropping very quickly. One more hit is going to come through, and Oracle finally finishes off with a kill. We through the trees and away the other side.
Oh, you freak. Oh, the vet dead.
Oh, goodness gracious. 11 to 11, but I'm not sure if it's worth it for Spectre dying. Well, looks like it is for everybody else getting some gold, but you're losing a decent chunk of it. I guess the Radiance is now going to be completed for Misery, and the towers are going to start to fall pretty soon here.
Yeah. Could probably kill his bear if he really wants to get to it. He's been to the Radiance here. And the body block's coming out from the walls. Not going to be in. No way. I'm not going to team it up. And then the... it's so close. 300 HP. And 300 gold.
My goodness. This is like one of those moments where you can just feel the tension. Like, they're, neither side wants to give up anything and are not necessarily like hesitant to go in for kills, but they're very, very particular about what fights they're willing to take right there. Some other games you might have seen other teams going for that kill on the bear and trying to dive deep for it, but Complexity saying, you know what, we're in a comfortable spot right now. We don't want to give anything away. They have lost a little bit of the lead off the back of that fight. It's not the worst thing in the world still, but I don't know. I think also the pipe is making a pretty big difference in this. It's great against the Radiance. It's really good against Earth Spirit and all the stuff that he brings to the table. Lone Druid is looking very strange right now in my tool effect. He looks like a weird guy.
Is yours. He looks in.
I think so too. He turned into a bear now. It's all good.
Okay. It's. Oh my goodness. But Necru 2 on PC. And he's very close to Necru 3. So once he has that, not only is he going to be hitting heroes for quite a bit of damage with the mana burn, but he will also be pushing a really, really scary burn. And the secret, I think about it, when Complexity goes to his push strat, or at least these pushes for Chessie, they don't have the best counter push outside the Lone Druid bear. They can throw a Spectre Dagger, they can throw a Ripple, but they don't have anything on the same caliber as a Shadow Shaman, a of the Light, and they're gonna try and go jump on the Swindles, who gets spotted out with the Horde at the vacuum. Well, might kill him while drop a bit low, but in the meantime, they're gonna try and go for a kill. They're gonna kill me, but he's gonna drop Z-Freak Diver, he's being healed up with the from Handskin, but looks like he's going to heal up and TP up. No one to chase him down. Unless someone else, but looks like that won't be anymore. One or two weeks, we lost Arctia in the top lane, and then we lost the OG as well as the in the top lane as well.
That was a really weird fight. It sort of spread out a couple of different places. I think that they realized with the Haunt that there was somebody else that they could go, but it all started with the charge onto the Earth Spirit by the Spirit Breaker, and then everything kind of spread from there. So a little bit different, a little bit odd. It again sort of speaks to the power of Haunt and what it gives you, the ability to choose the fights that you want, and they come out a little bit ahead because of it. But Radiant, considering that's down now, they need to be super careful. Blademail is picked up on the Earth Spirit. Pretty good. BKBs are still ways away for these heroes. And I don't think that you want to pick one up first. The only person that does have it right now is Limp. So, and actually, I don't know. I'm not sure if really, this is the problem with Earth Spirit in general as being played in a core role, is that there isn't a great item that he transitions into as like a super great damage dealer late game. They need Spectre to come online because Earth Spirit's, you know, damage is going to be that much less effective every time now.
He's in addition to, if he was, for example, if we was playing Puck. Let's see, Sindel's here though. He's spotted very deep in territory. He's still silenced up. He is going to be picked off by the bear right off the bat, so I'd really to save him. But in the meantime, Z-Freak came for a charge. He's trying to be healed up. Oracle Fates Eve as well. They're going to keep him alive though. They're stopped by a weak by Eternal Envy. They do pick up the Oracle in the meantime. The wolf is chasing down the bear. They kill off the bear. It's now the main bear. They want the bear. Misery going to be shut down by Chessie. Oh. Being for two trade, but all three cores, or at least two cores on Company, is still going to remain. There's two cores on Z-Freak. Unfortunately, those two on secret are not great at defending towers. They're gonna have to sack that top tier two if they want to come eat you in the enemy jungle.
Yeah, he's gonna be doing whatever he can again to try and clear out creep waves and get out of that fight. It just speaks again to the power of this Lycan. Like, you go immediately into shapeshift form, you start picking off supports right from the start. They're trying to do the same thing again on the side of Spectre, but he was able to, the side of Complexity was able to spread out a little bit more and pull Eternal Envy out of the fight. And because of that, you didn't have the extra damage that was coming in, just the sort of brute force from Lycan. It's really, I don't know, I'm getting more and more concerned about the sort of maneuverability as they do glimpse on back Complexity of them versus the ability to chase from secret. They need to have some more form of like concrete lockdown. Oh, big engagement. Wii is going to go down again.
Oh, detection. They don't know he's there. Don't have any detection. That's so... Oh, hurts. No Necronomicon for 8 seconds either. So if they did have that, they definitely would onto Wii, but... sort of prances there. In the meantime, Roche is being taken. So, second of the game, we have Cheese Roche. Oh, it's Roche. But still, just is still a great advantage for Complexity, or less. And the for secret, you know, he just is gonna be there. And live game updates, Vici beaten EG, OG beaten and home 2-0 Nesky.
Okay, so the big thing about that is that this means if they do end up winning this game for secret, it's going to be a four-way tie between LGD, Secret, Complexity, and eHome. So Secret still have a chance and they would end up going to tiebreakers, I believe is what that means. So this game becomes really, really important. Complexity, if they're able to win this, they're going to knock Secret out of the competition. And if they don't, then they're going to have to face off in tiebreakers against them.
Game is a lot of pressure. The teams don't know the statistics, so they'll figure it out after the games happen. So that's not good. Bad news. Secret doesn't know. They're really big in lower brackets. They're not completely not.
Right.
They still don't want to be in lower bracket, though. It's just too much pressure for the whole tournament.
Absolutely. Well, it does look like, at least for the moment, we're going to continue the pressure. As Limp already having the BKB, the Force Staff, and now the Aegis, they're ready to start to keep the pressure up on this top lane. And you know what? Secret doing what they do best. They're moving along this bottom lane, trying to keep it pushed out and apply pressure of their own, see if they can take it through one tower and possibly force some type of response out of Secret. They just need to buy time. That's what this comes down to. And if they're able to do that effectively, as the Manta style comes up for Spec, it's another really key item there. But doesn't have buyback.
If he dies, that could be pretty big. The only heroes that have buyback on Secret is going to be the Druid as well as the
Enrico back. Vacuum wall.
My client is using a couple of combos that's still coming through, limping the BP, trying to chase down Misery. He's going to be getting out of this. Puppy chased down the big bad wolf. Pops has got the combo. Threat from Puppy, the pause.
Oh no. This is not good.
This is a really good position to be for both teams. Chessie and Limp in the static field. Static storm, sorry. There is no kinetic field for 1 second.
Right.
So there is a kind of opportunity for Puppy to get the port in a kinetic field. We feel the damage they can, but there isn't the damage that can. Misery is not dead, so the bed will be raining down along the base. We'll take a look at this Limp. He gets entangled. He's gonna heal the fire at the aura. We'll keep him alive for much longer, though. He gets that eclipse deposit at least. He gets a kill to the lone druid, but he still drops. And lone druid kills off a second two. Well, Limp is dead here. And all of us in Complexity, they lost a massive team. My swindles as well. Limp is there from the Ruby Glimpse and back complete. What a disaster!
Oh!
I can't help but feel like that lag may have been a contributor to both teams being in a very weird, just in a very weird position.
You know, I can't help but feel the lag might have had an impact there as well. Oh my goodness, that's a 4,000 gold swing as well as around 5,000 experience. You're taking a look at an ultra kill from Spectre. He literally just bought a Manta style and 2,000 gold on top of it. You hate to see something like that, but regardless, oh man. It's all good. We're gonna move on. It's gonna be fine. Don't worry, guys. Everything is fine. Alright, let's
It's so hard. So hard to put something like that in line. Jesus.
I'm with you.
Actually, though, they are considered as a team after that. Just knowing they lost a big team fight, they know that there's a huge influx of going in the way of Secret. Like, the ground have completely turned upwards.
Yeah.
In favor of Secret after one fight. That's not the position that you want to be if you're complexity, because you're trying to beat against a Spectre and a Lone Druid.
No, definitely. The game just got a heck of a lot harder for them. And Secret are in a great position. This changes a lot if you're going to see Spectre be able to get an X item up very quickly. And it does look like Envy is going to go back for something at stage. I wouldn't hate a Diffusal Blade. I think that that sounds really strong, and that is what he's going to be picking up here. Look at this next team fight. This is going to be a really big game deciding one. And Complexity realize, you know what, everybody's off the map. We need to get the heck out of here. They can start to apply some more pressure. The other huge item that got picked up is the AC finished on Misery. So they're going to be able to pressure towers themselves. I don't think that they have to, you know, be in any rush to try and end the game right now, though. Honestly, they can take their time because they have the two better scaling heroes in the game right now.
And it looks like Fnatic Complexity is just going to sack T2. A little bit afraid of Secret, unfortunately.
No.
Well, now that Complexity are backward and Secret are going to be in a really good position here. If we take a look at a progression for both teams, Limp on the OG isn't looking as menacing as he used to be. He only has to be capable of 4 stuff, and 29 minutes, 30 minutes into the game, that's not that great on an OG. He's not hitting as hard as he would like to. Normally, he's picked up an A top. Rather than a 4-star, I can understand why you go 4-star after this game, but he needs intelligent beast items to make not just him more menacing, but to the sanities to deal more damage than it's currently doing right. And Z-Freak's going under into 5 arrows.
This guy awesome. Left
a bit of an adventure in his life. He'll be kept alive by and sanity eclipse. That was a stole of the sanity eclipse. Sorry. Ultimate is gonna not the clip that battles, and he's definitely gonna be there. Wait, okay, we're gonna try to fight this up. Pilot Eye almost dying. Maybe the ghost at the justice they get him. Look like he will. I know he's down there. They won't get the root. And they're gonna try and chase up to someone else. Poppy being chased up by all stuff. He kept them pissed there by hand. And he's gonna be there. He'll only be burning everyone's mana. And the bear, unfortunately, burning poor Hanskin, who will be dropping very surely. EE as well as Misery are still chasing. Two are dead. The Wolf has been slain as well. BKB popped by Limp to guarantee that he will not have his TP unfold.
Oh that my god.
Is not a situation that you want to be in at Complexity. And if that's the second team fight that it's gone terribly wrong.
Pilot Guy.
Why did you charge in there?
Pilot Guy is a god. Oh my god. Did you see that? He just like, he was standing there looking straight at the Spiritbreaker charging at him and just like raises his one little left hand in the air and lifts him up and then blinks away after the Chessie's chasing him on the wolf. Like the most ultimate of baits right there. And then getting away on less than 40 HP. Really, really impressive stuff. And then obviously the follow up from the rest of his team, Envy able to jump in on the backside and kill off Chessie with the Mance style into the Diffusal Blade damage. It's just exceptional play on both sides. And you know what? Despite that one team fight that was there and it ended up going a little bit south for the side of Complexity, I still think that this game was hotly contested at that stage and could have gone either way. I don't think that, you know, well, obviously one team fight is going to be able to be the difference to give them advantage going throughout the rest of the game. It could have gone either way regardless.
It could have. I still question that time.
Yeah.
What do you think was mindset behind him? Did he feel confident because he had allies behind him?
He's a spirit breaker, man. You got to charge on in there. You just have to do it. I think that's what it comes down to. Like, if you start to question yourself, I think on that style of hero, eventually you're going to not make the plays that you have to. So I don't know. I think that you can excuse a few questionable charges every now and then. Maybe also, you never know. Maybe his teammates told him to go in or something like that. Wii is going to be able to jump on now. Static Storm ends up getting dropped. Complexity is going to be further forward. Zane's Eclipse comes out. They get a couple more right clicks. Wii is going to be able to go down. I think that they end up getting that kill and getting out cleanly. They might think about going for a bit more, but with Spectre back up, they get the glimpse back. They're going to be able to bring Chesty here
Chesty.
And the quick kill.
Oh,
and now Hanskin too. Alright, charge away. It does look like Hanskin's gonna be able to TP out of there. Just nice little move. They get the lift. Oh, Limp is gonna go down. Jeez. Oh. Alright, Complexity are in a bit of trouble. And they're also gonna be able to kill off Hanskin here. He wasn't able to get out.
So considering the start, the Secret, they've made amazing comeback as a team, and it's not just because the Eternal Beam show, but it's also the supporting crew. Kai, as well as Poppy, with the plays, controlling the fights for them. Keeping it to get a kill on the Spindles here. Surge is out. Yeah, don't want to add out Spindles. Your team is in a lot of trouble. They need you.
There would be a dieback, too. So he needs to play really carefully. Let's take a look at the difference in net worth again. It's starting ever towards that 10k mark, and all of the items up. They're ready to go. They're not going to stop. They, you know what? They've seen the light. Tier 3 towers are going to start to go down. We have BKB that's up on your Earth Spirit. No more messing around. 20 seconds before OD's back up, and I don't think that they're going to be able to stop this. The thing to keep in mind is we do still have Vacuum Wall in 14, so there's a possibility you make something happen there. But they just settle for the range racks. Again, no need to pressure too much further than they need to. And 5,100 gold on spec. Scotty time pretty soon here.
Oh god, he is going to be such a monstrosity. I think the unfortunate thing for Completely is that Spindles has been getting very good initiations with the Vacuum Wall combo. It's just that they can't really combo it up with anything outside of Sandy's Eclipse. Mm-hmm. And if no Sandy's Eclipse, you've got nothing to really capitalize on the Vacuum combo. Other games where you do have things like Disruptor, or Winter's Curse, like any major ultimate that can synergize the Dark, it would be much more scary for Sea. It would be hesitant to even go anywhere in the team fights, knowing there's going to be an awesome combo. It just doesn't really matter anymore, because it's not doing as much as they would like to. Smoke in the Rouge, like, at the Aegis on Chessie, the ultimate from Puppy is in the locked in the Rouge, the Vacuum Care from Spindles, fucking the bear onto the high ground, but that's gonna get down. They check the Mazer Sack, their lip is being hammered by as best. He has to Astral. Chessie's gonna be losing his life. He loses the Aegis, they lose him, but that's gonna be the big battle going down to Secret. And Complexity, they get the Rouge, they technically deny it from Secret, but.
Oh my god. This is going to be it, I think. I think that they're going to be able to make this happen. I mean, you've got Secret that sort of came back from a terrible start, and the last game ended up not going the way that they wanted and been able to fight their way back into it. Right now, you've Eternal Indy with a casual Reaver and Ghost Scepter in his inventory. Tier 2 towers are going to go down, and I think that they're ready to push up towards high ground. Haunt has already been expended, but the buyback status is pretty much nowhere. They've only got the Spirit Breaker. Jump forward, lift. Swindles is going to end up going down here in a second. Can they get the Diffusal Blade? He's in a heck of a lot of trouble. The glimpse back again. Nice blink away, keeping them knife. Then Ryan, they didn't blink forward. There's the Vacuum Wall combo together. Might be able to turn this one back around. Z-Freak charging through everybody. Can they do enough damage though? That's the question. Limp jumps forward. Sanity's Eclipse out a second time through. The right clicks onto Puppy. He ends up going down. Wee is going to jump into the middle of Z-Freak. They're trying to turn this back around. With the Disruptor already dead, they might have a capability to do it. BKB has been popped. Continuing to right click. I don't think they're make it happen. Pi lifts and then blinks away. Exceptional play, and it looks like he's just gonna roll away.
Oh my goodness, they didn't even see many racks. Get the one racks, like one racks is gone, T3 is gone. This is such a huge opening Secret, and unfortunately for Complexity, they can't run 5-on-5 teams anymore. The OD just isn't big to do these devastating clips that we typically see from ODs. Like, do anything in the T5, a little bit of damage.
Yeah, no, it's not as much as you would really want at this point. I mean, let's take a look. OD has right now, well, he steals Int too, so that matters, but he's been forced to like cast it out right from the start, as opposed to being able to steal some Int and then go for it. Disruptor Yule's now also. We've got the Heart finished on spec. I think he's going to end up going for an E-Blade, I would assume. The Ghost Scepter, I think, is mainly just to allow himself to get back into sort of the Heart form if he wants to. But you take a look at this right now. You get one Haunt in, and you're pretty much going to kill off the Oracle. You get one Haunt in. You might be able to kill off the Darkseer because of Deflage charges, just to be able to slow him down.
Yeah.
Oh, and then the reality forward, they're going to be able to catch Limp here as well. A couple stuns come out. Can they actually finish him off, though? Not sure if it's going to be able to happen. Z-Freak is also caught. The jump forward are trying to be able to catch somebody. The Yule Scepter is going to be lifted up on the Z-Freak by the Oracle, trying to get in the middle of this fight, but Z-Freak is going to end up falling. Meanwhile, Chessy fighting him as much as he possibly can. I don't think he's going to be able to get a kill here, though. Continuing to try and kill off Pylai Dai. He doesn't have his Ghost Scepter anymore or Blink Dagger. He finally goes down. Where is the Spectre in all of this? Not going to be able to be there in time. The damage out on Eternal Envy trying to go 1v4. He might be able to do it. Honestly, they're never striking up. More right clicks coming in. He's getting out of there with the Ghost Scepter, and now Misery's back. The bear has come in. Wii is there. A couple more right clicks onto Handskin. He's going to fall. Five heroes dead, and GG ends up getting called. Secret bring it back, keeping their tournament life alive. My goodness gracious. Look like we'll be giving you the information as soon as possible. Oh my god.
What a way to start the day.
Absolutely. Well, yet again, you can